trying to say, you know, you mess up.
You want to do, you want to use a tripod or you want to use this?
Yeah,
it's not too cold out here, actually.
Per se.
Okay, what religion mean, bro? What's the meaning? What's the meaning of religion? Come on, man, you a religious and philosophy major?
Yeah, I got it. I want to be my best answer, man.
Oh, you said you, well, you go to school for religion?
Philosophy. African American history and African American religion too.
You know what philosophy means?
The study of ethics, logic.
What does the word mean? It's a Greek word. Philosophy consists of two words. Philē. That's where you get the word Philadelphia. Philē means love. Yeah. Like Philadelphia, brotherly love. So philosopher, sopher means, come from the Greek word sophia.
Yeah.
Which means wisdom, means lover of wisdom is all it means. So we're philosophers.
That's right, that's
right. We philosophizing out here. You know what
I'm saying? The word religion itself is uniquely owned, which means to restrain from truth, pretty much. You understand what I'm saying?
See, I figured you were about to give me a different meaning from what I was going to say. That's why I wanted to see what you were saying first.
Well, you just got to look up, you got to study the meaning of words.
Etymology.
Like,
yeah,
the Bible is a book of etymologies. So the Bible is a book of words, right? There's no pictures in it. So to be able to understand a Bible, you have to understand words. You got to be a wordsmith. You
got
to read
the documentary theory.
What is it?
That beautiful though. When you look up words, it helps you put things more into an image.
Theory.
Actually, help you put it into an image.
How the first five books of the Bible were written from.
You trying to say that they was written in a Babylonian period or something like that?
It's a theory that Moses didn't write the first five books of the Bible. That he got it from collective source of these other five.
Right. They try to say it was written after the Babylonian captivity. I've heard that. But you know, that's just madness. That's just that recent thing, what they call textual criticism.
It's right there at the beginning of the
and that's taught by colleges. All these colleges are ran by Freemasons and devil worshipers. You know what I'm saying? That's why they got all these Greek fraternities set up on every college campus in this country. There's a Greek fraternity where they give praises to Apollo, Athena, and all those other pagan deities.
I mean, y'all, I wasn't trying to come over here and disagree with anything.
Nah, man, you know, we're not here for you to learn.
We just out here to teach, bro.
I saw what you guys had here. I was like, hey, you guys make your stuff.
They don't teach this shit up in school.
Damn, what are you talking to?
Don't worry about it. If he wanted us to hear it, he'd come over here and tell us.
Right.
Don't never teach that in school, man.
I got a scripture for you, bro. I'm going to read you a scripture real quick. Let me get,
So do you guys believe? Well, I guess not, man.
Oh, that's it. I got it.
Right, let me read this real quick.
Okay.
John 4:22. This is what the Lord was telling people. He said, ye know not, he said, ye worship, ye know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. This is the key right here. God is a spirit, and they that worship him... Check this out. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. So everything we're dealing with truth. We're not dealing with emotions. We're dealing with truth.
Emotions.
That's your boy. He's all emotional.
What religion over there? Emotionally fired up.
What religion y'all believe in, man? If any.
Well, we believe in truth, not religion. You know, especially not in the modern sense of the word. We don't have a religion because that word religion connotates. When you hear that word religion nowadays, you think of mind control. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is. It's mind control. It's to brainwash people. To teach. These churches all out here, they're all set up by the government. They're all set up by secret societies.
So you're saying there's no good in religion?
None.
There's only good in truth.
Man. I don't have to debate that part.
Man started religion.
Yeah. Don't get me wrong.
Well, that's why I tell you.
I would still say there's still some good in
religion.
Well, yeah, no, when I say religion, not religion within itself, but within the people of religion.
No,
let me say that.
The people are worse than the religion itself.
Yeah.
You know?
Because really, like we said, we worship the Lord.
Right.
We don't worship religion.
No, trust me, I grew up Baptist.
I grew up a Baptist too.
Yeah, I've been getting away from religion because if you
the Baptist church is full of shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, but
now who do they teach you? Like, we'll give you one example. Who did a Baptist church and every other church teach you that the one they call Jesus came to save? Who do they say Jesus came to save in the churches?
Just read it in the scripture.
Yeah, we just read it. He said, "You worship, you know not what, for salvation is of the Jews." So the Lord came to save the nation of Israel from their sins.
He didn't. Religion, like the brother explained, pushes state say he's coming to save everyone.
Because this Bible is not for everybody. It's not for all nations. The Lord did not come to save Hamites and Edomites.
And that is true, man. From Joshua 11, this is Joshua 11. He tells Joshua to
slaughter them heathen, right?
That's true.
But nowadays,
what ISIS does it though.
Hey, this is read the scripture, man. Matthew.
Yeah, get that Matthew. What you got? Well, we just sometimes spirits shift on
gears.
How many people actually come by, man, and actually stop by?
Yeah. Man,
it don't matter.
We had many a conversation.
Well, I just a question. I just want to do a lot of people. You know, some people just see.
Well, man, we've talked to. We don't know how many thousands of millions we done talked to.
We
probably in the millions.
Yeah. You know.
Well, I was just saying. You know, some people might see this and just walk by. I didn't know.
It's not because most people do not interested in spiritual things. They're not interested in facts. They want to go about their life. They want to watch football.
That's easy.
You know what I mean? That's easy. They're not interested in knowledge. You know, say the scriptures say, wisdom and knowledge shall be thy stability in thy times. The wisdom and knowledge is what's going to stabilize you. It's what's going to fulfill you. You know what I mean? Not fleshly lust, going and partying, acting a fool all day, wasting your life away, being worthless.
Yes, fucking great. Fucking.
He gonna bring that demon out in that guy.
Hey, bro, that's deep. Is this true?
That's definitely true. That's a picture right there of them doing it.
I know you get from your naked eye, you just think they're just, you know, kissing the tummy or something like that.
No, they got video. You get on YouTube and type in Jew rabbi sucks what? Baby penis, and they have rabbis explaining to you why you must do it.
Videos on YouTube.
We had rabbis come out here and cuss at us because we said it was child abuse. And he looked at us like we was crazy. What you got? Matthew 15?
Well, you told him it was child abuse, and what he said? He said
what?
It wasn't?
He looked at us like we were filth.
That's deep.
Hey, read that scripture point. Matthew, was that 15, 24?
Shit, Hitler might have said something.
Hey, peep this scripture out.
Matthew 15:24. He answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So that's what the one they called Jesus said. Read that again. Tell me what this means.
I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
What does that mean?
My bad. I was reading that.
Oh, go ahead. Read it again. Read it again.
He answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
What does that mean? He said, I'm not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. The Lord, that's who the Lord came to save, was the Israelites. And now the Israelites have been scattered among all nations.
That's through the Bible, right? That's what the Bible.
Yeah, that's what the Bible says. And that's not what the churches say. That's what the Bible says.
That's over the key right over there. And over.
That's the key.
Yeah, over and over and over again.
That's right. You finish with that one up. Yeah. Here you go. This is Matthew 10:5. These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentiles and into any city of the Samaritans. Enter ye not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
I mean, that's plain, you know what I mean? But people who claim to be Bible believers, they don't even know that scripture exists. You know what I'm saying? Churches ain't teaching that.
One more scripture.
What school you go to? You go to this school?
Yes, sir.
How long you been going there?
Actually, man, it's my first year.
So you
just... No, I won't come to state transfer over here.
Where you from?
I'm from Youngstown, but I went to Florida State.
Troubled-ass Youngstown.
So you be studying a lot. You be studying all kind of mythologies.
Yeah, man. Well, like I said, man, I grew up Baptist, man, and
Messing your mind up?
No, not at all. per se, but my friend had switched over to Islam.
Ooh.
And then you got some good stuff about
our
that?
Our people waxing worse and worse.
But Islam, I mean, just look at the Muslims. That's all you gotta say.
Hey, them Arabs put us in slavery before the white man did.
Yeah,
and
they
told us Islam.
Yeah, right.
I wasn't necessarily.
You familiar with Moors?
Yeah, the Moors.
That's
what
they did.
They credit, well, they don't credit, but a lot of people say the Moors is the ones who taught Europeans how to reading.
Well, I mean, that's a lot of that's true because the numeral system that we use, like, you know, 0, 1, 2, 3, the way we write it, those are Arabic numerals.
Word.
Yeah, because before that, they used what? Roman numerals. You can't do sophisticated math with Roman numerals. You know, all the constellations in the sky all have, most of them have Arabic names.
I forgot the exact scripture that says it, what color Jesus was. And now my friend, showed me that. And I was like, kind of made me think, like, hold on, bro.
See what happened?
That is true. Like, how the hell do you have a white image of a Jesus? But we kind of, I never thought about it. But you kind of think, like, hold on, he's Middle Eastern. How's that man even white?
They know people don't read.
That's why I started.
The white man originates in the Middle East. The Edomites originate in Mount Seir, actually.
The mountains?
The Mount Seir, you know where Petra Jordan is?
No, I can't.
It's in Jordan. You know where modern day Jordan is? It's right by Israel.
Yeah, I know the Jordan River.
Yeah, Esau is actually our brother. Twin brother.
Jesus?
No, Esau.
The progenitor of the white race.
Yeah, he's a progenitor of the white, so-called
He's
white
our
race.
Actual twin brother. What a piece of shit of a brother he is.
He's the progenitor. The forefather. He's the, what do you call that?
Your boy getting out of here, man. He tired. He can't take no more.
Esau's the patriarch.
He can't take no more.
He was triple
on you. You could just come over here and sacrifice,
you know,
just listen to what they
got to
say.
Yeah, I mean, people get offended so easy, you know. The scriptures say, blesses, he is not offended. You know what I mean?
It does.
We ain't did nothing to that man. You know, we didn't go up there and say, you.
He's
just mad because we out here doing our thing.
Yeah, I'm going to get on through. I'm definitely going to, when I see y'all again, I'm going to have another talk.
You can get on Twitter, Kings of the Earth.
Kings of the Earth.
They got links to YouTube videos. You probably got, there's unlimited videos almost to watch.
Unlimited. That's the spirit of the Lord. You know, that's that living water you got actual proof of it on the internet, postal video.
Look up Great Millstone.
Great Millstone. Is that on King of the Earth?
YouTube.
And then
Kings of the Earth, Great Millstone.
Great Millstone?
Like, you know, like that.
See, my phone down.
Yeah, Kings of the Earth, you'll find everything on there. You know what I'm saying?
I'm check it out real quick. All right, big pentas.
All right, man.
Did he say big pimpin'?
That's the reaction he gave. After hearing what we gave him, it's like, all right, big pimpin'.
That's all right, though. I mean, he came over here, and we talked to him. We tried to give him some truth, man. That's all we can do. Whether they get it or not, who gives a fuck? I don't.
Your boy just got out of here, man. He don't even know where he going.
Who's that?
The dude.
Oh, that was at the bus. Hey, he couldn't take
come holla.
It. I mean, we weren't even out here but 5 minutes.
Yeah, right. And he was literally waiting for the bus stop. Before, he was here before us.
Just our presence. He didn't even hear our words. And just our presence vexed his spirit. I'm glad he left. Now I ain't got to hear that shit no more.
First Peter 2:6. Wherefore also it is contained in the scripture, behold, I lie in Zion, a chief cornerstone, stone. Elect precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded.
Yeah, he that believeth on him shall not be confounded. Keep going.
Unto you, therefore, which believe, he is precious.
Oh, that's another reason, too. You ain't going to see nobody come up here and confound us, stump us. You know, they going to catch us, You know they gonna what, make fools of it. It ain't gonna happen. It ain't happening yet, it ain't gonna happen. Go ahead.
Unto you therefore which believe he is precious, but unto them which be disobedient, the stone which the builders disallowed, the same is made the head of the corner.
Right. Yeah, that's the old saying. You hear people say the stone that the builders refused become the head cornerstone. Because you know what a cornerstone is? That's the cornerstone is the, isn't that the stone that makes the whole building stay together, right?
The cornerstone?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not sure. Bro.
I thought it was just the stone that had the date they built it on.
Like right there, like the corner, it goes both ways.
Maybe we should look it up. Go ahead, keep going.
And the stone of stumbling.
Yeah, it is. They got the stone where they have the ceremony and they lay it. Like the most important stone. Well, it's the most important stone. Go ahead.
And the stone of stumbling and a rock of offense.
Yeah, because the world refuses. Like I said, the stone that the builders refuse. The builders of this world is Esau. The builders of this kingdom is Esau. He built this kingdom. And he didn't build it. You know what I'm saying? We're not part of this system. We're not part of the government. We're not part of the courts and the magistrates and none of that shit. We're fucking slaves. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Go ahead.
Even to them which stumble at the word.
They stumble at the word. Yeah, they hear the word. They stumble at it. They get offended by the word. Or they just, oh, that Bible, that's some bullshit. That's the number one saying. The Bible's some bullshit.
A book of fairy tales.
A book of fairy tales. Actually, it's not a book of fairy tales.
It's a history book.
It's a history. A book of fairy tales would be something like the poetic Eddas, like the Norse mythologies, where they actually have fairies in the tales.
Lord of the Rings.
Oh, Lord of the Rings. Oh, yeah. Hey, actually, you know, Lord of the Rings, the author, J.R.R. Tolkien, was a Christian. He said the Bible was 100% truth. So there you go. Go ahead.
Whereunto also they were appointed. Being disobedient, whereunto also they were appointed.
Yeah, because our people is disobedient, man. They some disobedient bastards there. A bunch of murmurers. A bunch of complainers. Go ahead. Would you got something?
Hebrews 4 and 12.
Backbiters. Pieces of shit, child molesters, rapists, right. Fucking adulterers, faggots. That's our people, faggots and adulterers.
Yep. Well, Romans 1 going to it.
Yep.
With everything they are, you know. Oh, Hebrews 4 and 12. For the word of the Most High is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit.
Right, because this right here is a sword. It's our weapon. This is our weapon because the scriptures say the weapons of our warfare is not carnal. This is our weapon, is the truth, these words. And we come up, we swing it like a samurai swinging at your ass with a katana, chopping your ass up into pieces.
Blood squirting everywhere.
Yeah, because the scripture, that's why that dude got so offended. He just heard a glimpse of the truth. He just heard like a few minutes of the truth and he got offended. He fucked his spirit up so bad he had to leave.
Them demons was raping his ass.
That other dude wouldn't have stopped if he wasn't holding that sign up.
That's the spirit got on me to hold that sign up, you know?
Came up talking shit.
Didn't even look at it. Didn't even study the picture yet.
Well, that's because, you know, that's that he's pre-programmed.
And he was like, oh, yeah, you got it.
Well, all these people, they pre-programmed, you know? They've been brainwashed from their birth.
They're on repeat.
They're pre-programmed. Right, exactly. They stuck on goddamn repeat. You know what I'm saying? So we out here to reprogram them.
Hey, that's on point like a motherfucker.
Right, we in here to hack into the matrix and wake these motherfuckers up. He got that from that Sublime record. Oh, your hey, boy, Riley. Yeah. That's where I got the fucking, whatever. Hey, but we use different metaphors and stuff, and, you know, different sources.
That's what Israelites do.
You know?
What do you say? Your cosmetological, biological waste of your...
Something like that. He's like, I'm going to fix you. I'm going to fix you.
And of the joints and of the marrow and is a discerner of the thought and intent of the heart.
Right, that's why you can break down someone's whole spirit by the scriptures. The scriptures is like a spiritual diagnosis tool, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And you know the word diagnosis, I can't say it now, diagnostic. That comes from the word gnosis, which means knowledge.
Diagnostic.
So yeah, it gives you all the knowledge you need about somebody. So this is like a diagnostics tool. We can go by the scriptures and see if you don't line up with the scriptures, we know if we can trust you or not.
Right.
So you got that one kid we was just talking to. He said he was going to school for what? Philosophy?
He didn't know a damn thing.
Well, of course he don't know nothing. You know, he's young. He don't know nothing. Now yeah. He's going to school, and they gonna fuck up his mind even more. They gonna start feeding him all that Plato nonsense, teaching Aristotle, all this other crazy shit.
Yeah, he's looking forward to that shit.
Yeah, he's gonna be all messed up, right? He's gonna eat it up.
That's the wrong roll to eat on.
That is not the roll to eat. That's not even a roll. He eating what's he eating? Shit. He's like eating dried up dung cakes.
Right.
You know what I mean? Eating dung, baked dung cakes. Some dung rolls. He's all a fucking weirdo. Ooh, boy, that coffee was good, man, I tell you.
Yes, it was.
The UDF original is the best.
Yeah. Damn.
I got a drip left.
Wow, he chugged it. What is it?
That's that UDF original.
That is good, man.
Here you go, Art. This is 1 Corinthians 3:18. Let no man deceive himself. If any man among you seemeth to be wise in this world, let him become a fool that he may be wise.
Oh, that's scripture's on point, man. Right, because people, they go to these schools and they get a big head. They got this little paper. They went through a ceremony. They said they graduated, got a degree. Now their ego is puffed up. You know what I mean? Now they think they're hot shit. But they were really, in reality, they're really a fool. They live in a glass house.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Smart sister is going to school for a nurse. She don't know shit. That I try to tell her like that.
I don't want her caring after me. It's like that. Which one, your oldest sister?
Yeah. And she was like, well, I told her about the milk and how I got pus and the hormones and shit in that. And she was like, no, it's good for you. I but the shit they put in it.
Right, right.
You supposed to be a nurse. They supposed to be teaching you all this shit, but you don't know what. They don't teach you about the chemicals.
When you working in the nursing field, if everything is routine. You're taught routine.
Everybody's
taught to work outside the box.
Everybody's
like think for yourself.
What they call compartmentalized.
Where do they go for lunch every day? Everyone you see in the hospitals that work there, they eat fast food all day
long. Yeah, fast food.
Yeah, fast food.
You're supposed to be a doctor. You're supposed to know better to put that in your body.
And they order the shit in. I see them do it every day, man. They order the shit in. You know?
And most of those doctors, they going in the back room or having sex with the nurses in the closet, stiffing cocaine. They got unlimited amount of drugs in the hospital. Yeah, yeah. They in there popping pills all day, having sex with those fine-ass
taking
nurses.
Look at the doctors, how unhealthy they look.
Exactly.
You know?
And they all have them foul dogs. Because most of the doctors are Edomites, and they got foul spirits.
There's an Edomite for you.
Yeah, there's a lot of them East Indians.
Yeah, East Indians.
You know?
Moabites now. Yeah, they do. They take your blood. They'll do rituals with the blood, especially children's blood.
2-3 times a day you get in the hospital, they come and get blood, man. Every day. If you're in the hospital, they come and get blood, man. Every day you got that IV hooked up to your
They body. Probably taking that blood, drinking it, taking
yeah, of course they
bathing
do,
in it. You know? They showed you in that movie, that Tom Cruise movie, Eyes Wide Shut, and how, because he was a physician in that, a doctor in that movie, and it showed you. He came to find out, like, all the head people, the doctors and the judges, all the government officials, were all devil worshippers.
Satanic-ass world.
This is we live in a satanic system.
Physicians of no value.
You got many ex-members of the Church of Satan who exposed the devil worshippers, and they say, yeah, everybody in the high positions of power in this country are part of secret societies.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
They actually worship the devil.
Actually, what we all seeing is witches. They're all witches. All witches. We're surrounded by witches.
You can see it.
Yeah.
If you got eyes, you can see.
Hold on, let me get
let
this.
A blind look better. What is the scripture? The blind follow the blind, you'll both fall into a ditch.
Right. Hold on, let me get this real quick. Okay. This is Exodus 22 and 18. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live.
Yeah, you're supposed to put a witch to death. Yeah, I was just talking about this, because actually a witch is a witch, like in the Greek scripture, like in the New Testament when it says witchcraft, when you look it up in the Greek, it says pharmakia, which is where you get the word pharmacy. Now, a story just came out in the news yesterday. I was just reading it, and it said that pharmaceutical drugs cause more deaths than illegal street drugs. Check that out.
That's common sense.
But what happens if you get caught selling drugs on a corner? You get locked up, taken to jail. But these devils, these Edomites, they got pharmacies on every corner. They'll have a CVS on one side of the street and a Walgreens on the other side. And a Walmart down the street and a Kroger. They all sell drugs. And that causes more deaths than heroin and cocaine. That's a fact. And that's the people, who do you think is running this country? Oh, the corporations is running shit. Pharmaceutical companies got all kind of lobbyists paying off politicians.
This is Nahum 3 and 4. Because of the multitude of thy whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts.
That's America. The well-favored harlot is America.
That selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts.
That's what they do through their witchcrafts. And scriptures ain't lying. The scriptures is not a lie.
Ooh.
They tell you this whole nation was founded upon witchcraft. That's why George Washington was a Freemason. And there is no such thing as a good Freemason. Okay, my cousin was trying to tell me, oh, there's some are good, and they just want to love God and help people. Okay. Now, why they got meet in secret and have retarded ceremonies?
Closed doors.
I ain't buying that shit, man. You can believe that shit if you want. I'm not going to believe it. What's that old saying? You ain't going to piss on me and tell me it's raining. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to believe you.
Behold, I am against thee, said the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame.
That's what's going on right now through the world. That's why you got Vladimir Putin come out exposing in America on a daily basis. You know, he exposed the fact that Obama was supplying ISIS with weapons. He exposed the fact about how the Americans are knowingly poisoning their own population with genetically modified crops. He's exposing the fact that America is becoming a nation of faggots and homosexuals. And they ain't letting that shit go on over there in Russia. You know what? You know over there in Russia, too, they don't have... I was talking about this earlier. You know, in Russia, they do not have social security numbers.
What?
But I thought America was the land of the free. Russia don't have social security system like we got here. They're not numbers. That's why if you one of them fools, you believe America's the land of freedom, you're a dumbass. You're fucking stupid, man. You're beyond stupid. You're beyond retarded.
Verse 6. And I will cast abominable filth upon thee and make thee vile, and I will set thee as a gazing stock.
Yeah, so this country's going to be turned to a gazing stock. Keep going.
And it shall come to pass that all that look upon thee shall flee from thee and say, Nineveh is laid waste. Who will bemoan her? When shall I seek comforters for thee? Art thou better than the populace? No. That was situate among the rivers that had the waters round about it, whose rampart was... That's America.
Yeah. Well, kids, America. You know, Nineveh in the ancient world, that was founded by Nimrod. You know what I mean? And Nimrod, he was the creator of the New World Order system.
Ancient Nineveh.
He's the one that built the Tower of Babel. And that's what America's doing. It's a New World Order system, trying to bring all nations together just like Nimrod did back in Nineveh. back in Babylon. It's the same shit. They even got a fucking Hamite as president now. Just like Nimrod was a Hamite. What was Nimrod? Was a Cushite?
Cush, yeah.
Yeah, I tell you that in the book of Genesis. Nimrod was a son of Cush. And what are the Cushites? The Cushites used to live in the now modern day Cushites is where Ethiopia, right? But a lot of people don't know that the Ethiopians descend from the ancient Cushites, which come from Babylon, over in that area. But they all got pushed, the Arabs pushed them all out of there. So a lot of people don't know that. The back in the ancient world, the Cushites had a giant kingdom. But now they just in Ethiopia.
Okay, 1 Samuel 15 and 23. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is the iniquity and idolatry.
Yep.
Because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord, he hath rejected thee from being king.
Right, so that's why the Lord rejected all these fools out here. And that's why you see people walking around looking all abominable, walking around spreading their filth. You know, what's up? Fuck these people, man. These people, they're nobodies. They have no significance.
It's Ohio State campus, the land of the creepy crawlers.
You see some creepy shit out here.
Creepy shit.
But most of these people, they're insignificant, man. They don't even matter. They're a bunch of know-nothings, a bunch of useless eaters. Fucking worthless. That's why the Lord said two parts. What did he say? Two parts shall be cut off and die.
Two parts therein shall be cut off.
So two-thirds of Israel's going, they got to go, man. They got to be destroyed. So we ain't out here to save to teach everybody. We ain't, no.
They don't know mathematics and equations.
We ain't out here trying to waste energy to try to teach a jackass. You know what I'm saying?
Let two-thirds go over their head, man.
You didn't want to waste your time with them.
Right. Hosea 4 and 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
Right. That's why you see our people, they don't know nothing about history. They don't know anything about politics, history. They don't know the way government works. They don't know anything. And that's why they make the perfect slaves. That's why they're all destroyed.
Looking rats call them goyim.
The Jews call you goyim. They call you schleppers. Schlepper, that's like a worthless piece of shit, know nothing, jerk off. I don't know how you would translate that. You just a fucking schlepper.
I will also reject thee that thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power. I will also forget thy children.
Right, they forgot the law. That's why nobody keeps not even the Ten Commandments. They don't keep the first commandment, let alone the rest of them. They're a nation of adulterers, a nation of faggots. You know what I'm saying? Every lad, they all covered their neighbor's property, covered their neighbor's wife. This ain't no place to be living, man.
Covetous.
It's a covetous nation, right? Oh, yeah. There's a nun. She looked like a nun. I don't know. Oh, they don't even keep the Sabbath in America. There's no Sabbath in America. America runs 24/7 nonstop. Walmart's open every day. Kroger, the grocery store, I don't know where you got in the other parts of the country. The grocery stores are open every day. There's no rest. There's supposed to be a Sabbath, one day a week when nobody works and everything shuts down and everybody rests. But they try to excuse it. Well, the people, they get 2 days off and... No, everything's supposed to shut down on the same day. Everything. The whole city is supposed to shut down.
And be at rest.
And be at rest. None of this noise, none of this nonsense, all this loud confusion. And the scriptures say to what? What's the punishment for not keeping the Sabbath? is death. If you don't keep the Sabbath, you're supposed to get put to death. And America has defiled the Sabbath. What you got? Okay, read that.
Exodus 31, 12. And Yahweh spake unto Moses, saying, speak thou also unto the children of Israel, saying, verily, my Sabbath ye shall keep. For it is a sign between me and you. For it's a sign between me and you throughout your generations.
Throughout your generations. Means forever. Keep going.
That you may know that I am Yahweh that does sanctify you. Ye shall keep the Sabbath thereof, for it is holy unto you. Everyone that defileth it shall surely put to death.
Right. Because when you're making people work on the Sabbath, that's only something like a tyrant would do. You know, try to just slave driving. So that tells you the Lord is a righteous, the Lord is righteous and compassionate. He made sure that we had a day of rest, right?
He has your best interest at heart.
He's got your, exactly, that's a good way to put it. He's got your best interest at heart. That's why the Lord said don't eat pork, because pork is very unhealthy. Every obese person you've ever seen, fat ass, look at all these fat ass people in America. America has more obese people than every nation combined. And every last one of them, they're slurping up pork all day long, eating bacon, ham, pork chops. You name it, they're eating it all day, every day. Every fat person. Yeah. You're not supposed to eat pigs. Because like you said, the Lord's got your best interest at heart. There's a reason why he created the pig. The pig was created to clean the earth, not for you to eat it.
Same thing with a cat. Damn,
that dog is sweet.
Same thing with a cat.
Oh, that is a badass. Get him on camera. Look like Lou Dog. Ah. Oh,
look at the shit out of him.
That dog is beautiful. Man, I wish I had me a Dalmatian. Dalmatians are nuts too, ain't they?
They're crazy dogs.
Yeah. Look at him. He just got a free spirit. He just wants to go adventuring. Dalmatians. That's been a while since I've seen one of those.
They bite a lot of their own.
Do they?
That's a little one.
Yeah. Why is it a fireman always had Dalmatians? What was that all about?
Who knows what the brotherhood is doing?
Heavy raping. Well, firemen, they're no different from the cops. They're all part of fraternities. The fire department, they use the symbol of the Knights Templar. They have a Knights Templar cross.
Am I on that punk motherfucker, man? Oh, goddamn devil, man. Right. Go on, man. What we got?
What'd you read?
Whosoever doeth any work thereof, there that so.
Go ahead.
That so shall be cut off from amongst people. For
I read that again from the top. Oh, from the top of that scripture.
Where you at?
Exodus 31.
Yeah.
And 12. And Yahweh spake unto Moses, saying, Speak thou also unto the children of Israel, saying, verily my Sabbath ye shall keep, for it is a sign between me and you throughout your generations, that ye may know that I am Yahweh that doth sanctify you. Ye shall keep the Sabbath thereof, for it is holy unto you. Everyone that defileth it shall surely be put to death. For whosoever doeth any work therein, that soul shall be cut off from among his people. 6 days may work be done, but in the seventh is the Sabbath of rest. Holy to Yahweh, whosoever doeth any work in that seventh day, he shall surely be put to death.
That proves that America is not a so-called Christian nation as they claim. It's not a God-fearing nation. If it was, they'd keep the Sabbath. Everything was shut down one day a week, and it doesn't. The stores are open 24/7. A lot of them don't even close at all. They even got a store. They boast in their names. They got a store called 7-Eleven. It's open 7 days a week.
I said every person, you're false prophets.
You ain't talking shit because you got a beard, man.
Look at you.
What?
Every person might be
what?
Not even
so, hold up. What do we say that was wrong? What have we said that's wrong? Do you,
we're
of course,
about America.
We're talking about the Sabbath right now. We're talking, let me ask you a question. Without emotions, well, he's talking about the Sabbath. In America, do they keep the law of the Sabbath? Yes or no? So you say you don't have to keep the Sabbath. Is that what you said?
We live under grace now. Have you read your Bible lately?
So you don't have to follow the Ten Commandments?
The Ten Commandments are no more. It's under grace.
So wait a minute. So no, we can have sex with each other then?
Live under the law.
The Ten Commandments says thou shalt not kill. So I'm allowed to kill? I'm allowed to kill people.
You're full of shit.
So, take a
minute. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
No, you
the root,
know.
The root 4-1.
I know.
Dude, the root 4-1.
Read it.
This is the book of the commandments of the Most High.
We don't live under the law.
And the law that endures forever.
Read it again. Read it again.
This is the book of the commandments of the Most High. And the law that endures forever. All they that keep it shall come to life. But such as leave it shall die.
You live under grace.
But you drunk though.
You don't even fucking
but
know
you
what
fucking
you're talking
drunk,
about.
Though.
No, but I know the truth.
Didn't Jesus say don't get
yeah,
drunk?
Yeah, I know the truth. Even when I'm drunk, but you don't even know the truth. When
dude,
you're
you
straight.
Said you don't have to teach Ten Commandments, bro. So you saying we can murder people?
Right.
We're under grace.
Fuck our moms.
You know how
sex with dogs.
That's exactly.
We're under grace. We're under grace.
I asked you. We
hey, Paul, you going to go get a Great Dane with me? We're under grace.
Go get a lamb or a sheep.
Right. Let's go share a bitch and do a bukkake.
Yeah, let's
don't worry
go
about it, man.
Commit adultery with all
that's
these hoes out there.
Right.
That's good, man. You don't have to listen to us.
Grace.
You don't have to listen.
That's the spirit, because
don't listen.
Exodus 31:16. Wherefore the children of Israel shall keep the Sabbath, to observe the Sabbath throughout their generations for a perpetual covenant.
Mm. Perpetual means forever.
Forever.
False prophets. You think we're under the law? You guys are like 2,000 years old.
Ecclesiastes 15:20.
You have 15.
He hath commanded no man to do wickedly.
He commanded no man to do wickedly.
Neither hath he given any man license to sin.
What about teaching? What about that?
Hey,
yeah, stop doing it.
Hey, I'm spreading. You are.
No, you said
it. I know what I am.
Dude, you just said
I know what I am.
Yeah.
Don't even tell me what I am.
You a question.
I know what I am.
You're a goner, dude.
You guys act like you are fucking so much better. You don't know shit.
I never said I was better than you. I never said that.
You know shit.
What is the word iniquity means in Greek?
It means without law.
You don't know shit. It means condition without law. That's the fucking
you don't know shit. You're false fucking
prophet.
Fuck.
You're
false
prophet.
You better leave Jezebel alone. You better leave Jezebel alone. Because she got you all fucked up.
That's your boy.
Be hours above.
Came back, had to go get a beer and go get another one to get his liquid courage. You know what I'm saying?
I'm not losing sleep over that guy, trust me.
I think that was cool. He made my night.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm disappointed the motherfucker leaving, man.
Oh, I was actually thinking he was gonna get some courage and throw the beer at us or something, but watch, he's gonna look at us.
That's a food for your ass.
Look. Oh, he didn't even look. He's mad. We really upset that guy that much. We didn't do nothing to the guy.
We marked his ass up, though.
All we doing is out here teaching. You offended that bad by people teaching the Bible.
You false fucking prophets. You don't know shit.
The spirit of demons, boy. Whenever the truth is out, the demons got to be there,
and
too.
He was drinking that natty ice.
And he cut the hell out of himself, too, didn't he?
Yeah, I'm here.
He said he even got to keep the king. Keep the Ten Commandments.
We're under grace.
Keep it. They don't realize what they be saying.
We under grace, he said.
But if we was inside of a church building, you know what I'm saying, wearing a robe and having a pagan ritual, you know, got the holy water. You know the holy water comes from the pagan church, right? Oh, you know they got holy water in churches. You know Aleister Crowley? In his witchcraft books, whatever you want to call it. I forget which book it's in. But he tells you that holy water, plays a major part in that witchcraft. That's why all those churches have holy water. But anyway, he would never go into church and say that to one of those preachers.
Hell no.
Never.
Man, hell no. Never. That's the doctrine he loves, man. And first of all, we never mentioned the word prophet, but he brought the word prophet out, so we must be the true prophet.
Must be.
We never said nothing about us being prophets, man. But that spirit of the prophecy is right here. So it's obvious that we're the prophets of the Lord, man. And that's, the people hated the prophets of the Lord.
That's just that demon inside him jumping all around, bouncing around.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Every truth is present, the people, Satan's in the midst of it. No.
I don't care how cool you try to be with somebody, too. Actually, sometimes the nicer you are to them, the more angry they get. You notice that? Because back in the day, I would have cursed that until my vein popped out of my head.
We curse his ass out anyway.
But I'm not popping no more veins in my forehead over these fools. You know,
curse his ass out through the scripture. He gonna die a miserable death too. And he was a Jake too.
Oh, he
was a Jake too.
He looked like
clown Ishikar though.
He was probably raped by his father growing up.
Yeah. Mom and dad gave him a golden shower.
Pissing on him while he's sleeping.
Wake up, honey.
I mean, a lot of people really are abused by their parents though, growing up.
Yeah.
Hear about that more and more, about how children are getting raped by their parents.
I'll tell you some shit that my grandmother did to my aunts and uncles, man. It's some crazy shit, man. And I'm not exaggerating what they did to my aunts and my mom and my brothers and shit. Woo. My grandmother was a witch, man. My mom's mom, she's an actual witch.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, she's an actual witch. She locked them all in the basement and told them to just do whatever y'all want to each other.
Damn.
She locked them in the basement for like 4 straight days and didn't let them out. And they was in there having sex with each other and everything, brothers and sisters, man. What up?
There's some sick shit going on out here.
Yep, and the funny thing is my mom tried to do the same thing with my brothers and sisters. My mom tried to do the same shit, man.
That's fucking crazy.
Yep. And I remember I walked in the door, and my sister Via had an iron chasing my brother. I threw it at
him. Oh shit.
Yeah, and cause I just walked in the door, and this was in
irons flying.
87, 88, 89, 90, somewhere right there, right? And my sister Mia was screaming like, that motherfucker tried to rape us. And my mom told him to go in there to do that shit, man.
Ass bugged out.
Yeah,
man.
My sister Michelle and Mia, man, my oldest sisters, man.
That's some demons on
him, man. And they fucked his ass
up,
man. The same motherfucker that raped my niece when she was 2 and 3 years old. The same motherfucker that was down the street. Remember when it was in the news chasing a bitch shooting at her? The same motherfucker, man.
I know people that said they got raped by their grandpa, you know, raped by their dad, molested them.
Right.
You know, just, you hear about it all the time. Like, damn, why'd you reveal that to me? You know? But, I mean, that's the spirit, though.
It's a common practice.
They got to get it out because they hurt so bad. You know, they get that shit. They holding that shit in.
They
got to tell somebody.
Yeah.
Once that happened, they probably think about that for the rest of their life.
Yeah. It fucks them up, man.
That's how people come gay a lot.
Yep. Well, that's what the gay people say, is that they recruit people by raping them.
Mm-hmm.
Once you rape them, now they feel like a faggot.
Because
their manhood's been violated. And then they, for them to feel right, they go take it out on someone else.
Yeah.
A woman, she's probably scared of men. Like, if she got raped by her dad, she's probably scared of men. So she
now they should be a lesbian now.
So hating.
You hear that now.
Hate men.
I've heard women say that. Yeah. Like, men are fuck men.
Yeah.
Like, that's
fucking pigs.
That's fucked up though, man. That's your own flesh and blood, man.
I know this one kid, it wasn't his parents. I know this one dude I just met a couple months ago, but he said, he was in the care of foster parents, was even worse than real parents. And they said they locked his ass in a dog cage. And it was on the news. He got locked in a dog. He said he's in a dog cage for like a year.
Right.
Like in a kennel.
Here in Columbus, just read the other day, a couple had a daughter, and they had her locked in a closet, and they still had her locked in the closet, duct tape, man.
Oh shit.
Duct tape. Yep.
You hear about it all the time. I see the stories on the news. I was watching Sotomayor, and he always bring them stories out. How about a bitch will go to the club, and they come home to find out one of the kids stuck the other kid in the oven and cooked them.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
These people that let's get that scripture in Lamentations. Let me see if I get that.
There's this one, another one, just bitches, these bitches, they give their kids NyQuil, knock them the fuck out so they can go do their thing, you know?
I see my one dude, he's passed away. he gave his kids a Xanax.
Oh, my goodness, man.
And they were gone. I couldn't believe
down.
He did.
He should have been put together.
He's out of there.
Yeah.
He's, you know, he, yeah, the Lord took him out a few years.
Yeah, most I got a plan for these people, man. You don't do that to no innocent.
No.
I ain't gonna say innocent child, but you don't do that to no child. No. Because ain't no motherfucking body innocent.
Nah, not even children are innocent.
Right, that's right. That's right. Shit, this previous lives, you know?
Yep.
That motherfucker was, you know, that baby could have been an evil son of a bitch. Evil son of a bitch.
His name, King David's son, John Rippers.
He did rape her. You're damn right. And she tried to tell him, don't do such evil. Yeah, hell yeah, they killed him. And then after the motherfucker raped her, he threw her out. He was like, get out of here. And she's like, you doing more evil. And you know, a woman ain't got no goddamn sense. But she was reminding his ass how evil he, you know, his evil deeds, his evil acts.
Hey, where's that one scripture? It's been so long since I got it.
What you looking for?
In Lamentations, the one about the woman of Zion. I think it's in about the guy from my house.
Hold on. Oh yeah, I got it. Let me get it, bro.
Man, we ain't brought. I can't. We used to bring that out every week.
I actually used it the other day.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I'm about to go home and read the whole book of Lamentations.
It's a bad book, though. Hold on, my hand's freezing. Okay.
Because the scriptures tell you how cruel these women are, man. Especially the Israelite woman. The Israelite woman's a super demon.
My mother, when she was younger, she let me and my sister smoke weed.
Oh!
Wow.
I remember that shit.
That ain't shit. Head. I've been smoking weed since I was 3 years old. No, man, you were talking about crazy. My mom, I hope she didn't ever find this YouTube channel, boy.
Right.
Now, I ain't gonna tell you.
Get the fuck out.
I ain't gonna tell you what I seen.
Get the fuck out.
I seen it all. Man, I seen parties, bitches naked, dancing on a table. My mom and her friends, they used to run around the house naked. They be pregnant too, shooting people with their titty milk.
Woo!
They shoot you with it across the room. Yeah. They used to have crazy parties. Man, I was smoking weed, drinking beer when I was... As soon as I could walk, I was stealing beers, shit. Because you know the drunk motherfuckers, they leave beers everywhere.
Right.
That'd be, they be like, they ain't gonna miss this. Kyle, take it down in the basement.
What's up, devil?
Shit, I remember one time I went to go piss and mom was in the bathroom getting her pussy ate by some dude.
you better hope she don't find a channel.
she gonna get her anonymous email.
It was that dude. It was Monkey.
Monkey. Monkey.
That'd be fucked up, boy.
Yeah, that was my dude when I was a little kid too, Monkey.
Here we go.
Now I seen some crazy shit growing up, man.
Blow my nose real quick.
Well, my mom, she repented of a lot of that.
I ain't never seen no crazy shit.
She apologized 1,000 times for all that shit.
Yeah.
Well, you know, people do dumb ass shit, man. Especially Israel. And
personally, I believe your mom is sincere with it, too.
Yeah, she is. Next step is to get her to stop eating pork. That ain't never gonna happen.
That ain't gonna happen.
Nah. That's the last thing they'd never give up. They ain't gonna give up that pork.
That pork, that's the last one.
That bitch told me she's going on a diet, but she didn't quit eating pork. She bought like 5 pounds of bacon.
Oh, man.
She's like, I gotta eat all fat and no carbs.
Man, that's that dumbass shit with some Atkins diet or something.
Dumbest shit I ever heard.
When the dude Atkins died from eating too much meat. There you go. I don't eat hardly no meat at all. Look at me, do I look unhealthy? I don't eat. I'm a vegetarian. I eat greens. Look, you wanna see my biceps? Look at that. The world's strongest men, all they eat is spinach. They be killing spinach. Hey, he the one that got me on the spinach, boy.
Spinach, green shit. Everything green.
Green, man. I just love it.
Everything green, man.
I just love it. I gotta have. I gotta have me some spinach.
Gotta have.
When I wake up in the morning, I gotta have some spinach.
Gotta have it, yo. That's first thing. That's my first meal every day. Is that green smoothie, man? That green smoothie.
Hey, that sounds good. I wish I could get me some smoothies.
Here you go.
Just pour a little vodka in there.
Vodka?
I don't know. There's a million things you could do with a smoothie,
put
boy.
Some whiskey in that.
Some whiskey? Anything.
That's my shit. Some whiskey.
Shit.
That's my shit.
That'd make me mean.
Here you go. This is Lamentations 4 and 3. Even the sea monsters draw out the breast. They give suck to their young ones.
Yeah, even the sea monsters will love their children, care for them, nurture them. Keep going.
That's right. The daughter of my people is become cruel like the ostrich in the wilderness.
And the Lord said, the daughter of my people. Who's the Lord's people? The Israelites.
The nigger woman.
And he said, all right, he said, it's, read that again, man. It's what the Lord said about his own people, about the women.
Even the sea monsters draw out the breast. They give suck to their young ones. The daughter of my people is become cruel.
She's cruel.
Like the ostriches in the wilderness.
Show no love to her children. Here it is, she done left the baby's daddy, kicked his ass out, whatever.
Got him locked up.
Called up the got him locked up. Called the police on him. Lied, said he hit her.
Got him killed.
Got him killed. Yeah, like that. You know what I'm saying? Set his ass up.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know she'll call the cops for you hitting her when she's hitting you with a frying pan, throwing shit at you every day.
Provoke the whole situation.
Yeah, provoke the whole thing.
Yep.
And then here it is. She done kicked the dad out of the house. Got rid of his raggedy ass. And then now she getting child support, and all that money's going to her. And it's not supporting the children.
That's evil.
That's evil. I've seen it with my own eyes over and over and over again.
All of us seen it. All of us. We're witnesses to it.
And then, like, I was watching the videos. Get on that YouTube channel.
Is her belly out?
Yep. But that your boy Tommy, what's his name? Tommy Sotomayor. I can't even say the dude's name. He's got all the stories about the women on that channel. About the Israelite woman. Go to Tommy Sotomayor's YouTube channel and he'll show you all the horrific stories about the Israelite woman. About how, like that one I said, the woman, she had to go to the club, right? She left all of her kids at home. And while she's at the club, one of the kids put the other baby in the oven and cooked his ass to death.
There's another one that put him in the microwave.
Yeah, put him in the microwave.
Yeah.
I seen this other story. This bitch went to court because she. Her kids was not doing what she wanted, so she beat the hell out of them, and then she tried to cover it up and stuck them in the freezer.
Yeah, they was in there for a long time.
Kept them in the freezer.
Yeah, for weeks.
And then she was in the court. You can watch the video of her in the courtroom explaining to the judge about why she had to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Like she didn't do nothing wrong.
Yep.
She really thought she was justified in her own mind.
Yep. Black queen.
Fucking demons, man.
That's right.
Like
that's
my baby's mom is a goddamn demon, man. She's like... She's worse than the ostrich. What is that?
Ostrich in the wilderness.
She's a cold-blooded reptilian is what she is. Shit, you know what I'm saying?
Shapeshifter.
She's a goddamn shapeshifter. Oh, she did shapeshift. She used to be skinny. Now she's all fat.
Wow.
And she's a goddamn demon, man. Got no love for her own children. You know what I'm saying?
That's all.
She only uses them as a...
paycheck.
It's a paycheck or is a... She uses them as leverage is what she uses them for.
Yep, that's right.
That's all she uses them for.
No love.
Huh?
So like the woman, like, you know holidays, y'all be eating like a feast, right?
Yeah.
Like, there's like Thanksgiving, whatever. The bitch been broke as hell all week. All of a sudden, Thanksgiving comes, she's gonna ask all of her lovers for money and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And they give you a feast.
Yep.
Like, why can't you do that every single week?
Yep.
Every single week, they always spending shit on their hair, giving us, feeding us chicken and fucking gallons. Going out and doing nails and shit.
They came and they ain't got the motherly touch like they supposed to have.
Yeah.
That comforting touch.
A
they
father
got
will
that.
Bring real love in the house.
Yeah.
He'll feed your ass, you know? A father.
That's what
father.
I do. I cook for my children.
You know? Mother.
My baby's mom can't even cook macaroni and cheese out the box right.
That's shit. What they give them. That box shit.
It'd be all runny.
Yep.
You know
that
what
shit
I mean?
You add water and prepare.
Man, you eat my macaroni and cheese, babe. You be in heaven.
Yeah.
Like, this shit is good, boy. You know, you gotta do it. I mean, I be taking my cooking serious, even if it is out the box.
Right, right.
I be adding extra
shit. Right.
You know what I'm saying? You know you gotta add some extra cheese to it.
Yeah. Shit, man. Child's supposed to have a real meal to eat, man.
Yeah, real meal.
You know? You know, give them a fucking TV dinner or the fucking goddamn TV dinner. That's a lunch. That's a snack for a child, man. But you gotta prepare an actual meal for a child, man.
I gotta say, my mom, even though she fed us pork and shit growing up, but man, she cooked. She, her ass was in the kitchen every day.
Yeah, my mom cooked.
She was getting down. She still does it. And she be getting busy in the kitchen.
And I still, to this day, ain't met a girl that had cooked. Well, maybe a couple.
Very rare.
Yeah, but maybe, yeah.
You lucky if she can get you some ramen noodles.
Yeah, my mom could burn, man. My mom made me a chicken breast the other day with some rice, and that shit was banging.
Oh, yeah.
Real.
And my, that's how my mom, she make everything from scratch too.
And I was thinking when I was eating, I was like, did she poison me?
Hey, you never know. I be thinking that too, bro. Because women go nuts sometimes.
Although, every time I see her, man, I ain't never did it in my life, man. Every time I see her now, I give her a hug, man. She a demon though,
well,
man.
That's your
but
mom,
I got a hug. Yeah.
Just, even if right. Your mom is a demon.
Right, right. I give her a hug. I ain't never did that with my mom, man.
I even tell my boy, even though I been talking a lot of shit about their mom. I still tell you, she's still your mom, I guess. Yeah. And you gotta respect her.
You said still your mom, I guess.
But she's fucking evil.
Yeah.
I remember, look, I'm telling you, my baby's mom is so evil. When I used to have other children come over to that, when we were still together, other little children would come over, they'd be afraid of her. They'd be like, they start like scooting away from her.
Wow.
Because she's so evil. They can feel the evil spirit. And she used to always tell me too, I hate children. Like, damn, wow. Bitch.
Damn.
She would say that. She said, I hate children. I hate kids. Like, damn, you bitch, you evil.
My two youngest weren't raised by their mom. My wife raised them, you know? Until they got old enough, like around the age of 8, I'm around 10, 11, or 12, that's when she started taking on some more of a so-called responsibility. But even before then, she was still collecting the income tax, claiming them as, you know, on her taxes and shit, man. When we was the one raising them two
Yeah,
children.
That's how my baby's mama did it.
Yep.
Here it is, back in when me and Paul was together. The whole time, and shit, at that time, Paul was the one fucking
paying all
the bills and everything.
I remember.
And then she fucking claimed them.
Yep, I remember that issue came up.
Fucking whore, man.
Right.
What's up? How y'all doing?
What y'all think about this picture here? Give me a pin. Give me your pin. Don't get it. Revelation 1 and 3. No, that ain't 1 and 3. That's 1 and
3. 1 and 13.
Folks, let me show you something. This picture, this image, is not biblical. Everything about this image is not in the Bible. So where does this image come from? You got to ask that question. You know, this picture, this image, this man, during the Renaissance period. The 1400s, son of the Pope, his real name is Rodrigo Borgia.
Yep.
That's his real name. This man was a tyrant. He was an actual tyrant. He was raping his sister, Khadijah. I can't remember her name, but anyway, he was raping his sister. I think he killed his brother.
Lucretia Borgia. His name's Caesar Borgia.
Right.
His father was the Pope. But anyway, make a long story short, the popular image of Jesus that you see today is based upon the image of an actual man, the son of a pope, who lived around the year 1492, the same time as Columbus.
That's why this picture, right? That's why this image is here. They're the same people.
Okay.
But the actual image of the Lord is... You got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
White supremacy. Revelation 1 and... Revelation 1 and 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool. As white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So you don't see no white in his hair. See that white, like world. As woolly, what it say?
White as wool.
What is wool? The texture of wool. You ever seen like a brother? You seen brothers with the afros?
Yeah.
You see something like you ever seen Gene Wilder?
Yeah.
Got a little afro though, don't you?
Yeah.
See, Gene Wilder was a Jake. He was an actual black man. Man, he looked like a white. He's a light-skinned black man. You know, Leonardo DiCaprio. John Travolta,
YouTube,
I'm talking about. Not YouTube, YouTube. Y'all ain't nothing but black people, man. I can tell by your spirit. Your light-skinned black people. You see these two right here? Light-skinned black people. But anyway, white like wool.
And his eyes were as flaming fire, and his feet like unto fine brass.
His feet like unto fine brass. What color is brass?
Green.
My brass.
Gold.
Brass.
Brass.
Gold.
Brown. You had a penny. You seen a penny?
Yeah.
Right. His eyes were red as...
Red as fire.
Red as fire because he drank wine. Dealing with the stressful of these dumbass Israelites, wicked-ass Israelites, the foolish people. The foolish people.
Yeah, our people is known for being foolish.
Fools.
Look, you should even tell you that, I finna act a fool this evening.
Right.
But yeah. Like there's a lot of deception.
Well, this world is based on deception.
Yeah.
That's what the devil
This whole system that we live in.
So the country that we're on right now is something that we overtook.
That's right.
Well, they came over here and said it's going to be ours and pushed Indians back to almost to extinction. Yep. So there's many tribes today that are
getting
extinct.
That numbers scripture.
Numbers? Oh, yeah.
And they forced that shit. That's white supremacy. Then they told that they're the Jews, but really, the Native Americans, they were Jews too. They were Israelites.
Well, they from the, you ever hear the lost 10 tribes of Israel?
Yeah.
Because, you know, going back about 2,700 years ago, the northern tribes of Israel, there's total, well, you got 12 tribes, but 10 of the tribes came over to the Americas over 2,000 years ago to escape all the turmoil that was going on over there in the Middle East. It tells you about that in the Apocrypha.
That's how the devil knew to come over here because of our book.
Yeah, when Christopher Columbus came over here, they teach you in schools that he discovered America, but when he got here, people was already here. Yeah. That doesn't make any sense.
Christopher Columbus is not your people.
No.
That's a totally different nation. He's from a totally different nation than us.
Yep.
Here you go. This is Numbers 35 and 33. So ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are. This one you want to?
Yeah. 35.
For blood it defileth the land, and the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, but by the blood of him that shed it.
You know, that's what's coming is the evil days are approaching.
Ooh, Jacob's trouble.
It's about to get evil out here.
Jacob's trouble.
That's why we out here to warn the people.
Thank you guys.
Yep.
Very informative. I appreciate you.
Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
I got a precept for that actually.
I got one too.
That goes to that Revelation 13.
That's where I'm at.
Oh, go ahead. You already got it. That's the spirit.
I was in the wrong one. Revelation 13 and 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
Right. He brought up that point about the Indians. Yep. You know what I'm saying? He's the one that brought that up, so he's just testifying to the truth.
That's right.
And he said they came over here and they just pushed all the Indians out, almost drove them to extinction.
And it's funny how they accepted the image of the one in the Bible and rejected that one too. You know?
Yeah, that's true, right?
Yep.
They know they're Jakes.
Accepted that.
Only Israelite would speak truth like that.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So, that's common sense. So that's what you call karma. You kill somebody, you're going to be killed.
Damn right.
I mean, you know.
Damn right.
Remember, we looked that word karma up, and it was mean to make. You reap what you sow, man.
It's not throwing.
Yeah, you can't find it after. It's right by Amos. I already told you when I was young, man, Obadiah was the first book I ever read in the Bible. Because, you know, when you're little, I was like, I'm going to read the shortest book. Well, it was like, I didn't know about Jude yet, but I found Obadiah. It was only one page. I was like, I'm reading this one.
Yeah, that's funny, because I never knew Obadiah was in there.
I've known about that since.
That's one of the hottest books, man.
Because we always had this big, giant Bible that was on the coffee table. Yeah, I used to always read it.
Yeah.
You know, I knew about that Solomon scriptures, I am black but comely. I've known about that since I was a little kid. A lot, you know, certain scriptures I used to read when I was little. Didn't really understand them, though.
Yeah, it's Obadiah 1 and 15. For the day of Yahweh is near upon all the heathen, as thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee.
Oh, that's a good scripture.
That reward shall return upon thine own head.
Like a boomerang. Coming right back at your ass.
I felt that shit in my chest, man.
I mean, that's, you think the Most High is a righteous power, man.
That's right.
So you're going to tell, you can't just keep doing wickedness forever and expect nothing bad to happen to you. So like this government is so wicked and evil, they done, get on Google and type in democide. Democide has killed more people in the history of the earth than anybody. And democide means death by government, okay? And the government is responsible for more deaths than anybody else in history, especially in the 20th century. In the 20th century, the government has killed more people than anyone else in the history of the planet Earth. That's a fact. So you got all these stupid people, they claim, I'm proud to be an American. Yeah, you're fucking stupid.
That's another thing.
That's an oxymoron.
Because they say they're African-American. Africa was named after a white man.
Africa's...
Yeah.
Scipio. He's a famous general. He's the one who finally defeated Hannibal or something like that, right?
Yeah, they say he was a Jew.
That tells you that the motherfuckers, what they call it, brainwashed or whatever, because they named after two white people.
Well, that's like that script. Here, I'll get that scripture.
Edomites.
Yeah.
I'll get a scripture, a precept for that. That's in that book of Psalms 49.
And they versus white man.
Because what happens is the Esau goes around, conquers land, then names them after himself.
Yeah. Psalms 49?
Yeah, Psalms 49.
Yeah. Marie, just reach that real quick.
Yeah, go ahead.
This is 1 Thessalonians 1 and 6. See, it is a righteous thing with the Most High, Yahweh Shai, to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
Esau, starting with their system of control, their government, their magistrates, the judges, the cops, the politicians, all these fucking faggots.
Yeah.
Excuse my language, but they're fucking faggots. Oh, the other, especially two-thirds, the baby's mamas. The baby's mama, you gonna tell me the Lord is not gonna repay these whores for all the evil they done?
They will not get a free pass.
Nobody's getting a free pass.
That's right.
You know, the only people that's getting a free pass is the people who repent and call on the name of the Lord.
That's right.
We've all done wicked shit. Mm-hmm. We're all actually guilty of death.
We're washing our hands though, bro.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying, because the Lord has redeemed us.
I know. I'm with you. And to you who are troubled, rest with us, when the Lord Yahweh Shai shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not the Most High, Yahweh.
With flaming fire, that's talking about those missiles. This ain't talking about hell or underworld. It's talking about missiles, death. Keep going.
Okay.
You know, I was just reading this right before we came out here today. That's the spirit. I was just reading this in the Greek.
And that obey not the gospel of our Lord Yahweh Shai, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power.
The everlasting. Yep, keep going.
When he shall come to be glorified in his saints and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. Wherefore also we pray also for you, that our power will count you worthy of this calling and fulfill all the good pleasures of this goodness and the work of faith with power, that the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai, the anointed, may be glorified in you. Is that how you say it? The anointed?
Mashiach.
Mashiach, right.
You can say Ha Mashiach, that means the.
Ha Mashiach.
Ha means the, so.
Right. And ye in him, according to the grace of our power and the Lord Yahweh Shai.
He knows it said everlasting destruction.
Yeah, that was it. That's it.
But everlasting destruction is not talking about like you going to go burn in hell forever.
Right.
That's just a permanent destruction. People take everything out of context, especially the way it's written in English. You know. What you got? Oh, I was about to read this. Psalms 49 and 11. Psalms 49:11, their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever, and their dwelling places to all generations. They call their lands after their own names. So that's why they came to America, changed the name. This ain't America. Okay.
Fucking Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah, Columbus, Ohio. This used to be the Gadites' land. The Israelites used to live here. You know what I'm saying? The Scioto used to be the lifeline of Ohio.
Used to be clean.
It used to be clean.
So, now, due to milkshake, it looks and smells like shit.
Ohio used to be beautiful, man. Just think how beautiful. Even this used to be all, like downtown used to be all woods. Just think how beautiful that was. Back in the day, the Scioto River was blue. You could see the bottom of it. You could take a drink out of it.
Imagine the Scioto where it's coming from, where it's going, man. Yeah. And all the waste and piss and shit in it, man.
Done polluted the whole land. And that tells you too, they were a lot cleaner because they didn't even have any diseases over here. They didn't even have the common cold was unknown. When the white man came to America, that they was wiped out, the natives, just by the common cold.
When Esau came, these motherfuckers.
Yeah, when Esau came over here.
That vibration out there, that this double going.
Yeah,
down.
Esau. Oh, you know, I was watching this documentary or a lecture, and they said, check this out. In South America, besides the guns and the slaughtering of the natives, of the Israelites down there, and the Incas, you know what one of the number one killers of the Incas were? And you know the natives of South America was? Y'all know? A disease, but disease from what though?
Smallpox.
From swine. The pig was not a native animal to South America. So when they brought the pigs over here, and the pigs had all kind of diseases in them that the people over here weren't used to, you right? And it just started spreading like wildfire, and it killed millions. Tells you how they were a lot cleaner over here, you know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah. Paradise.
They wasn't eating swine's flesh down there. They didn't even have no swines. Right, it probably did look like paradise. Just think when you first came over here. Unless your ass went to the Aztec temple.
Oh,
that wasn't
man.
No paradise.
Oh man. what's that movie Apocalypto? Give me a little glimpse into that.
Yeah. You didn't want to go up there, boy.
Oh, my goodness.
You probably want to kick it up north with the Iroquois or something.
Here you go, Revelation 11 and 18. And the nations were angry, and thy wrath is come, and the time of the dead that they should be judged, and that thou shouldest give reward unto thy servants the prophets, and to the saints, and them that fear thy name.
Them that fear thy name. So that's key. You got to know that the name of the Most High is Yahweh, and the Jesus' real name is Yahweh Shai. You got to know that.
You got to know. And them that fear thy name, small and great, and shouldest destroy them which destroy the earth.
To destroy them that destroy the earth. They didn't terrorize the earth, man. Look what they did to the earth right here. They came up with this stupid invention called cars. You guys drive cars? But they made it so you had to drive these fucking things. And if you're not driving a car, you catch a coda bus. Otherwise, you're not going to eat. You know what I mean? And they turned the whole goddamn city into a slab of concrete. That cannot be good for the earth to turn everything into concrete.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, if they had their way, they would pave. They would turn the whole earth into a metropolis.
Won't be a rainforest anymore.
They're working on it. They've been working on destroying that rainforest.
Them Israelites over there fighting back, too.
Yeah, they are fighting back. Yeah.
The motherfuckers be coming up missing and shit over there.
They
seen again.
Esau has a disdain for life. A disdain for oh, shit. I was just thinking, I was like, damn, I'm starting to sound like Alex Jones or something. Really, anything that's beautiful and fucking pure, they hate it. You know what I'm saying?
Fucking potatoes like this big.
No, yeah, you go to the store, right? Potatoes shriveled up.
There's no fucking seeds in the apples and grapes. You can't
find them too.
Well, if they are seeds, they're GMO seeds. They're designed so the seed won't even grow after you plant it. So you can't make no money off of it. What kind of fucking madness is that?
is fucked up.
That's going beyond polluting the earth. That's just, that's just evil, man. It's like that movie. What's that new movie, Total Recall? Y'all seen that, right, with Colin Farrell? When they show you about how the mark of the beast is, in that movie, everybody got microchips in their hands and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, that movie's bad.
And they show you that most of the world became uninhabitable because of all the GMO crops destroyed the whole earth. And what was the only two parts of the earth with was left untouched was what? Australia and Britain or something?
I can't remember.
But yeah, it goes, that movie goes into it about how they destroyed the earth through their tampering with the genetics of the plants.
Right. This is Hebrews 12 and 16. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau.
Esau is profane. If y'all didn't know, is they eat up, you get all these different crazy theories on the internet about the Illuminati bloodlines, who's controlling the earth, the royal families, the rock. Well, who's that? This is the key. Who's the head family on the earth? It's the Rothschilds. Rothschild. Roth means red, okay? Which red, he got that name from Esau, because Esau is red. And you can get on Google, just get on Google or DuckDuckGo, whatever you use. Type in Rothschilds or Esau, or Rothschilds or Edomites. Jews are really Edomites. Oh, here, let's read it right here. Real quick, I gotta get this out. We ain't brought this out in a minute. Check this out, because the Rothschilds are so-called Jews, right? But let's see what the so-called Jews say in their own writings. This right here says, Edom is modern Jewry. That's from the Jewish Encyclopedia, okay? So the Jewish Encyclopedia, written by those Jews themselves, it says, Edom is modern Jewry. Down here, it says, strictly speaking, it is incorrect to call an ancient Israelite a Jew or to call a contemporary Jew an Israelite or a Hebrew. That's from a Jewish almanac. So they tell you in their own writings that they really descend from the house of Esau.
That's right.
So read that scripture again.
Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright.
Right, so all them elite banker families, all, you know what I'm saying? All these super rich elite people they talk about, the one percenters, those are all Edomites. That's a fact.
For ye know how that afterward, when he would have inherited the blessing, he was rejected, for he found no place of repentance.
He got no Esau can't repent. Okay? Esau can't be saved. There will be no Edomites sitting on thrones in the kingdom, okay? Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
We see Esau with palms in his hands.
And who's teaching that? Bubble Eyes?
Oh, Bubble Eyes. Yeah, he's a big weirdo. Oh, Bubble Eyes was teaching that the Most High is androgynous.
Lord, have mercy.
Saying the Most High is both male and female. And that's what Freemasons teach.
That's Baphomet.
That's Baphomet, right. The Baphomet. He's got a breast and he's got a dick.
Yep. That's what Michael Jackson was.
Yep.
That's what Prince was.
Yes. Oh, hey, I heard somebody say that. Yeah. I was watching some GMS videos right before I came out. And one of those brothers said, I'd never heard him say, but he said Prince once said that everybody has a little princess in them.
Yeah, yeah. And he also said that, I can't even think of the words.
But didn't you say he had that one video, or you was at a concert or something, and he played a guitar solo, and his guitar started busting a nut?
Yeah, that was, Prince playing, he was singing, it was two songs. He do it in two or three songs.
Is it on YouTube?
It should be.
Because I was telling somebody about it, they didn't believe me. I gotta find it.
Yeah. It's at the end of Purple Rain, the movie.
Oh, it's in the movie?
Yeah, but he does that in all his concerts.
Oh, does he?
Yeah.
Oh, I gotta find
his
footage.
His guitar busts a nut. It's coming while he's jacking it off.
Yeah. Prince is out there, man.
He's somewhere else.
Hey, he's a good musician, but
yeah, he's somewhere
else. He's a Jehovah Witness, you know that?
Yeah.
So that's what Jehovah's Witness gets you. it turns you into an androgynous being. And Prince's symbol, his name ain't even Prince. The artist formerly known as Prince. Because remember, his symbol was the man and female symbol mixed together.
Male, female, androgynous.
It's androgynous.
Androgynous.
She look like she's straight out the Persian Empire.
man.
Oh,
I can't wait to do some things.
What's that?
Seven women. You ready for it? You ready? Because if you're not, hold on. Here we go. Is that seven women definitely coming, man? As far as these motherfuckers in the world go, they break their promises. Most High ain't breaking his.
I don't know, but in this kingdom, I'd rather spend my time with a computer than one of these hoes.
There's gonna be no computers then.
Oh, we're gonna have something far surpassive. Well, I'm talking about right now.
Oh, right.
Cause you, man, right now you be living out here, man. You like looking at this bitch like drooling over a hoe.
Yeah.
When you get with this bitch, you disappointed in every way.
Every way. Yeah.
When you finally get with her, you get let down.
Mm-hmm.
Like the pussy wasn't as good as you thought it was.
Yeah.
This shit, bitch got.
Calm.
She got warts and. Now you gotta go to the clinic, and I'm not saying it happened to me. I'm just saying.
Because
these women are filthy, man.
Scripture says men are deceived by the beauty of women.
Exactly. You gotta watch these whores, man.
They be, man.
I'd rather get with a cool ass bitch than a fine ass bitch.
Richard, the most beautiful women be like seriously like bug the fuck out.
They are. They're all bugged out.
Like, I'd rather be with an ugly bitch, cause you know.
That's what I said.
More sincere.
I'd rather.
On just an average bitch that's struggling like you.
Yeah.
You know, she's more sincere. And these bitches that got the good jobs, high paying jobs, man, you got to work on
you
them.
You don't want no high maintenance hoes.
Yeah, you ain't got no time for that madness.
Nah.
Man. And they the ones that require more of your time. The ones that's more established, so called established.
I ain't got no time.
Right, you ain't got that time.
I ain't got no time. I got like maybe one or two nights a week.
Right.
You ain't catch me then, you ain't catching me.
Yeah.
Shit is so hectic, I ain't got time to do the shit I need to do.
For real.
You just waste all your time with a woman.
That's crazy, man. Bitch texted me the other day, and because I didn't want to spend all night and day with her ass. I already just beat it up that same morning, man. And I was like, well, I got to do what I got to do, and I get with you when I'm finished, all right? She sends me a text, motherfucker, you just like all the motherfuckers, and don't text you, call me again. And that's exactly what I did. I didn't text or call her for a couple of days, and this bitch started ringing, blowing my shit up, man. See, they fucked up. They're screwed up in the head. They confused, man.
They confused.
I did exactly that. I didn't call her ass,
but if,
you know?
But if you texted her like crazy, then she don't want to talk
to
you.
Yeah, right.
It's a psychological mess.
My sister be doing that all the time, man. Like a dude, he see all clingy and shit.
Yeah.
But if the dude ain't, like, if he's too much into her, she complains. If he's not too much into her,
yeah.
She complains.
Yeah.
Like, which one do you want, bitch?
Right. See, they're foolish, man. They prefer to just lie. You gotta lie to them. You gotta deceive these hoes, man.
Ever since I got to this knowledge, you know, I don't be losing sleep over a bitch no more.
You know?
I used to do that when I was young. You get, like, I gotta see you, baby.
Yeah. I grew out of that when I was 18, 19.
It's like, now I don't want to see nobody. I want to be left the hell alone.
Am I taking claim to this one? Am I taking claim? They ain't bad looking.
I told you. That's the Sean.
Yeah.
All day.
What's up?
She look cool.
She smokes.
Dude. Yeah, I just want to study and be left the hell alone, man.
1 Corinthians 7:26. So I suppose, therefore, that this is good for this present distress. I say that it is good for a man so to be. Art thou bound unto a wife? Seek not to be loose. Art thou loose from a wife? Seek not a wife.
Yeah, seek not a wife. Yeah, because like when you get into the knowledge and you start getting deep, you be studying this shit. You ain't got a lot of time to be bullshitting because you so deep into that. To the knowledge, you know what I'm saying? And so when you get with a woman, you just want to make it quick. it's like I'm not trying to sit there and go, oh, we're gonna go on a trip together. You know, I ain't got time for all that shit, man. Yeah.
And that's what my family's trying to plan right now, a trip.
You don't want next flick and chill.
A trip to
Netflix and shit.
They trying to go to Vegas now, man.
Well, if I had a girl who would want to live with me and... But that ain't gonna happen.
It's just one time.
Derek posted a picture a couple weeks ago. It said, fuck Netflix and chill, suck my dick and leave.
Yeah, but that's nasty, though.
But and if thou marry, thou hast not sinned. And if a virgin marries, she hath not sinned.
Like, for example, like me, you know, I got a wife. But I ain't into my wife all like that. You know, we do our thing when I need to do my thing.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
When I do need to do my thing. And she knows to leave me the fuck alone. You know, until, you know, unless she has that itch. Shit. Ain't nothing wrong with it.
Nah, ain't nothing wrong.
You know, because it has its advantages, too.
Hell yeah. Well, I would say it's just hard. It's hard to find that cool-ass woman. Like,
if you do find it, it's a little blessing.
It's a little blessing.
Yeah.
Because I'm just not going to just be kicking it every day with any old hoe.
It got its blessings and its curses.
Right. Because what a proverb says,
man.
What's that, Proverbs 30 and 14, I think? It says, who can find a virtuous woman? Because her price is far above rubies.
Yep.
So not just because a bitch look good and shit don't mean I just automatically want to spend.
Don't make her a good woman either.
Nah, hell no.
Damn. You know these goddamn women around here. No good woman.
You gotta try the spirits. That includes women.
Shit, for real.
Nevertheless,
just have you healed the fuck up.
Nevertheless, such shall have trouble in the flesh, but I spare you.
Just like I was saying, you know, comes with that curse too, man. When you living with a woman, man. Cause they get that mood, the time of the month, man. These bitches open their mouth, trying. My wife hit me with an elbow the other day, man.
And that's when women go nuts. They start throwing dishes at you.
I didn't feel like having sex. I didn't feel like it. Bitch hit me with an elbow, man. Shit. Bitch is crazy, man. She know how to push my buttons.
Shit.
She knows how far she can push me, not to go over that problem.
That's why I gotta give me one of these Chinese bitches. That maybe she can clean my room for me.
Bitch actually said, fuck you,
but this I say, brother, the time is short. It remaineth that both they that have wives be as though they had none.
That's right. That's why I got hit with that elbow.
And we ain't,
I sound like I didn't have one.
Yeah, because our main focus is the truth.
That's right. Gotta do what we gotta do, man.
If you can get a woman, hey, that's great, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But don't be losing sleep over and wasting every hour of the day. You be on Facebook and every other website just trying to talk to bitches all day. That's too much work and effort. I ain't got it in me no more to go through that.
I don't remember last time I've been on tag.
Playing cat and mouse.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's been literally like 4 or 5 months since I've been on tag. Probably longer than that.
That shit's weak now, though.
Yeah,
hey,
yeah.
It ain't good as it used to
be. These bitches, they lost on there, man.
No, I be get on there. Yeah, you see the little feeds they be posting.
Mm-hmm.
It's bugged
stupid
out.
Stupid shit.
Most
they're,
of them.
Their little sayings or proverbs and shit.
Yeah,
stupid shit.
You hate seeing that shit, man.
Yeah, man.
That shit vexes your spirit.
Yeah. Stupid shit, man.
Some woman knowledge.
Stupid.
Oh, that's like your boy going back to Bubble Eyes. Did you see the video where he's teaching the Most High's androgynous? And in that video, he had women up in the class, and they was all getting in the spirit when he said, oh, the Most High, he's got the woman part of him, too. And they was like, ooh, yeah, baby, ooh, yeah,
that's
come on, bring
crazy.
It. Amen.
That's fucking crazy.
You know, that really gets the woman riled up when he was feeding into that.
That's fucking crazy, man.
That is nuts.
I was hoping you was going to send me the video, but I wanted to see it. So I went to his site looking for him.
I seen it on one of the GMS, I think it was the GMS brothers from San Francisco. It was the one, that's when I first learned about watching that video. And he played a clip of it. I didn't see that. I didn't go to his actual channel. I don't know where their channel is. I don't be watching their videos. I don't want to hear from them. That's just bugged out. He's actually teaching that. I mean, it's not surprising, though. At first, he's already teaching about mermaids. And,
oh, yeah. I saw that one.
And he said, oh, yeah. He's like, when you die, you remember that dream you had when you look up? Yeah, but that's when you die is why you're going to see the rest of that dream. What the fuck? That don't even make no sense. Bubble Eyes is gone, man.
Yes, man. Oh,
and he's just all bugged out eyes. You see why they call his ass Bubble Eyes.
Polite too, man. That motherfucker getting more and more bugged out. Polite too. You saw how Tommy Sizemore just using basic common sense, cut all them motherfuckers
did
up.
He?
That phone conversation they had.
He had a with Polite?
Yeah, with Polite and
really?
And Side Nigga.
How long
and
ago
one
was that?
Other dude. It's recent too.
Oh, I gotta go watch.
It's recent. You'll see it.
As soon as I get home,
it's
boy,
recent.
I'll watch that one.
It's like it ain't no more than a month old. Maybe
oh, yeah?
A little older.
Okay.
But just basic common sense, that Polite just hang up the phone, man.
Did he?
He couldn't say shit. He couldn't say shit.
Most High gonna get Sotomayor too.
Oh, yeah.
He's gonna get his
unfortunately.
Head. Even though he's doing something good, the Most High gonna get you.
Yeah, he gonna get it. He gonna get it.
It's a crackhead.
He probably whoop his ass a little bit. He might wake up.
He gonna lose that house.
Yeah.
Huh? It's a crackhead looking dude went up there. He said, how's a woman got? Like, how's that baby got in there? And the dude's like, He started fucking up. He said, then he started explaining his sperm and shit. Yeah.
Man, this is retarded.
Yeah, stupid motherfucker.
I mean, it just sounds, because you know why people have those doctrines. Well, here, let me put it in so you can understand. Why did Tupac make songs about women? Keep your head up, dear mama. Why? Because there's more women than men, and they're the ones who's actually buying the records. Okay? And the men, like nowadays, men, we're the ones that's on Pirate Bay downloading the shit. We ain't paying money for your shit. You know what I'm saying?
That's right, man.
That's the woman. The woman's the retard that goes and buys every DVD as soon as it comes out for $30 a piece.
Oh, she'll put her credit card online and buy the music and get it downloaded.
Yeah.
iTunes,
Google Play, all that.
Yeah, they do that shit.
That's
retarded.
I mean, women love to blow money.
Yeah.
So if you're going to start your own religion or church or be a teacher, anything you do, you must cater to the women if you want to be successful financially.
And you got to have a wife so she can be an example to the women.
Yep. That's like Nathaniel.
Yeah, because then she was, when she like, didn't he put like a website about the women doing something about hair or some shit?
We talking about Nathaniel?
Yeah, it was
he had something about daughters of Sarah or something like that.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Some weird shit. It's just weird, man.
That's some bugged out shit,
it's
man.
Bugged out. I don't be watching their videos. Only time I watch their videos is when some shit comes out and I gotta go check it out just to witness the madness myself. Cause I can't sit through an hour long video of that shit.
Oh, hell no.
I got very little time, and the time I do got, I want to spend it learning some real knowledge.
It's some real shit.
It's some real shit. I'm trying to go deep, okay? I'm trying to get it in.
Yeah.
When I be studying, I don't be bullshitting. I ain't got time for that nonsense.
For real, here you go, Romans 16 and 17. Now I beseech ye, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. For they that are such serve not our Lord Yahweh Shai, the anointed, but their own belly, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts.
Yeah,
of the
good
simple.
Good words, man. Just fair speeches. Like that's all the preachers ever. They get mad if you use one cuss word. They'll say you're evil because I said shit or fuck. But if you use numbers fair speeches and you talk all soft and you make everything sound all good and. You know, it's like a used car salesman. That's what they are. They're no different. They gonna tell you everything you want to hear just so they can make the sale.
Yeah.
You know, they just want to make the sale. That's what it's all about.
That's right.
Just like you got they gonna blow smoke right up your ass, man.
That's right.
But I mean, a fool get caught up in that. See, we ain't fools. We're not dumb. What's that old saying? We wasn't born yesterday. What's another one?
It's not our first rodeo.
What does that mean? It's not our first rodeo.
Yeah. It's like saying not my first ride.
Yeah, something like that, yeah.
This is Isaiah 39.
I've been around the block a couple times.
Right.
Yeah, that's that old South End shit.
Okay. That this is a rebellious people, lying children, children that will not hear the law of the Lord.
Yeah, our people do not want to hear the laws of the Lord. They don't want to hear about the Sabbath. They don't want to hear about not eating pork. They don't want to hear that they're an adulterer. Oh, these women definitely don't want to hear that they can only have one man. No, they don't want to hear that. Go ahead.
Which say to the seers, see not, and to the prophets, prophesy not unto us right things.
That was your boy early. He told us that we was false prophets. Yep. He told us to shut up.
Yep.
claim on that.
Prophesy right not unto us right things. Speak.
Nice.
Speak unto us smooth things. Prophesy deceit.
Yeah, they want us to tell them lies. You know, that they want to hear lies because lies are easier.
Yeah. They ain't gonna openly come out and say, lie to me.
Right.
But their spirit,
that truth, just like that scripture in Hebrews says, you know, the word's a double-edged sword. Yeah. It's quick and powerful.
Yep.
Sharper than any two-edged sword.
That's right.
I mean, the truth will come out, it hurts. The truth is hard to swallow.
That's the same truth.
It's just like in that movie, The Matrix, that one dude, what was his name in that movie? No, that one dude, he went to the agents and told him to put him back in the Matrix.
Yeah, right.
And
right.
He said, make me an actor or something. It, as he took a bite of his steak, he said, and he knew the steak wasn't real, and he said, ignorance is bliss. You know, ignorance is bliss.
That's a bad movie, man.
It is a bad movie.
That's a bad movie, man. That's a spiritual movie.
What was that guy's name? I used to know it. I used to quote it all the time.
That's a spiritual-ass movie. Deep as shit. It ain't nothing but full of deep, dark parables, man.
Yeah, it's a parable. There's a lot of secrets in there. You get on YouTube and look in Hidden Symbolism in the Matrix. There's a lot of hidden shit in that movie.
Wow.
Like one of the license plates on the car was a scripture.
Right.
So just weird shit like that, you know?
Get ye out of the way. Turn aside out of the path. Cease the Holy One of Israel to cease from before us.
Yeah, they didn't hate the Holy One of Israel.
Yeah.
You know, they despise him. Keep going.
Wherefore thus saith the Holy One of Israel, because ye despise the word, and trust in the oppression and